You might already know that there are different versions of Google Chrome for different release channels. There's the regular stable version, but also beta, dev, and canary, where each of them is further ahead of the regular stable version. These different versions are also called flavors of Chrome, but there is one other flavor that is different than the others, called Chrome for Testing. It's not a release channel like the others, and it's not even listed on the main landing page for Chrome along with the other versions. So what is it, and how is it different? That's what this video is about. The Chrome for Testing flavor, which actually has its own icon just like the others, has one major difference from the others, and that is it doesn't auto-update. In fact, it can't be updated. It's not even a version that you install. You just download a zip file with the installation directly in it and run the binaries directly, and there are individual downloads for every possible version for then all the different release channels, but they would be Chrome for Testing versions of those builds. Now, the idea is that the Chrome for Testing versions are as close to the regular version that a user would use at that build number as possible. There are some differences, I'll get to them later, but you might be wondering, what is actually the point of this? The only difference, effectively, is that it doesn't auto-update. Like the name suggests, Chrome for Testing, it's for testing purposes, mostly for developers, but also for automation. For example, imagine you are a developer and you're working on an extension or a script or something on your website, and maybe you're having issues with it, so you're debugging it, and you want to have as few variables as possible. So you want Chrome to stay put, because if it starts updating, that's going to change things, potentially change how the bug behaves, and that just makes it even more difficult to figure out what's going wrong. Or imagine you're app stops working from one version of Chrome to the next, and maybe you're wondering if it's a coincidence or if it really is Chrome itself, and that way you can download an older version of Chrome that's not going to immediately update back, so you can test before and after, see what the difference is from. But another use case is automation. Maybe you have another program or script that automates Chrome to do some kind of task, like running tests on your own website, and you don't want the tests changing from one version of Chrome to the next that you didn't plan on and messing up the tests. So that's another thing where it would benefit to not have Chrome changing itself, because if it updates, it could break the app and then it just screws things up. So what are any other differences besides just not auto-updating? And there are a few, both in the program itself and stuff surrounding it. So the first difference is how you download it. There's no big direct download button, download testing, because the whole point is you're going to be looking for a specific version to use with it. And there are different API endpoints where you can request the download link for a specific version. They do have a dashboard that lists at least the most recent versions of Chrome for Testing for the different release channels, or on a GitHub page where they have links to the different endpoints. You can go there and see the actual raw JSON and look at all the available ones they have and download any specific build directly. And typically you would have a script do this. Now, for the program itself, there are some slight differences in the interface that I noticed. The first big one is that there's a persistent banner at the top that always shows, and it says, Chrome for Testing is only for automated testing. For regular browsing, use a standard version of Chrome that updates automatically. So obviously they do this because they don't want people using it as their main browser. So it's pretty much there to just annoy people out of potentially doing that if they were going to. Another small difference is I noticed in the settings menus, at the top left, it says Chrome for Testing, whereas other versions just say Chrome, even the beta version. And I also noticed that in some places it says Chromium instead of Chrome, like the sign-in profile section. And just like the other Chrome flavors, it has its own user directory in the app data folder, in Windows at least. It says Chrome for Testing, whereas the other ones are Chrome beta, dev, etc. It's possible that the Chrome for Testing version also has different flags enabled or disabled by default, because I did notice that despite being on the same version that I had on my main browser, that's the stable one, the Chrome for Testing had the new extensions menu that normally on the regular version of Chrome has to be enabled through a flag, manually changing it. So it seems that there might be different configurations of the flags that are different for this one. For example, apparently for at least one experimental feature, in the blog post they mention that that feature is explicitly disabled by default for certain other versions and instances of Chrome, and one of them is Chrome for testing. Now, that being said, I don't believe there's any actual additional hidden features or exclusive features for Chrome for testing. It's just going to be slightly different configurations of maybe certain flags that are still available in the regular version. It's just that their default value might be slightly different. After all, the entire point of Chrome for testing is so that any particular build is as close to the regular Chrome version as possible. Some other interesting notes. I did mention there's a GitHub page where they list all the different endpoints. And you can see, for example, if you go into the known good versions API list, it lists all the testing versions going way back to version 114 from 2013, which is in 2023, which is when they first released Chrome for testing. So that makes sense. And you'll also notice that it doesn't just have the major versions of Chrome, but each patch version in between. So there's a whole bunch for each major version. So it really is like every possible version you could want. So if you haven't seen this version of Chrome before, now you know, and don't go using it as your main browser. But maybe if you do need to use it for automation purposes or something, you know that there's an option for it. And of course, if you enjoyed the video, be sure to give it a big giant thumbs up. It helps out. And if you want to subscribe, I try to make videos about twice a week, so it should be worth it. If you want to keep watching, the next video I'd recommend is where I talked about the hidden good version of Google that they hid behind a certain setting that I'll put right there you can click on. So thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.